Hello students, today we are going to discuss reaction of phenol. Okay, so in that reaction phenol, so today we are going to discuss the one more important reaction, that is the Raymer-Tamman reaction. So students, Raymer-Tamman reaction is a very important reaction. Okay, so many times in JEE as well as NEET exam, they are asking the question on the basis of this reaction. Okay students, so how they will ask the question? So generally, in Raymer-Tamman reactions, we have to prepare the salicylamide. Okay, the question is asking like this. So just see the main reaction here. So in Raymer-Tamman reactions, we have to use the phenol. Okay, so it is one reactant. Phenol reacts with chloroform plus NaOH and it undergoes hydrolysis. So in JEE and NEET exam, directly they are given the question like this, and they are asking here, what is the product? Okay, so what is the product here? We will get a salicylamide. Okay students, so in the salicylamide, they are asking the question in JEE, directly we pass what product will get, and sometimes they are asking which intermediates will get during the mechanism of Raymer-Tamman reaction. So we will discuss the mechanism here. So directly I am given the reaction here, but now we discuss in details about the mechanism of Raymer-Tamman reaction. So students, so in mechanism, first of all you see the which reagent you are going to use. Here mechanism is the CHCl3. CHCl3 is nothing but chloroform and NaOH and hydrochloric acid, we can hydrolyze this. So first in mechanism, in step first, chloroform reacts with NaOH, means nucleophile will attach, so easily it can lose the water molecule like this. So the water molecule will lose, because this chlorine have the more electronegative, we can share the pair of electrons over itself, and easily we can abstract the, this nucleophile is a abstract the proton from this chloroform, and what happens, the H2O will remove, and here we will get this intermediates. Okay, so but it is in unstable now. So here just see, minus charge will come here, and these are the two lone pair of electrons. What happened now? So this, now it is unstable, this chlorine is easily removed, students. So this Cl is removed, and here we get a dichlorocarbene. This is a Lewis acid. Okay, so CCl2 is nothing but dichlorocarbene. It is one of the Lewis acid, and that Lewis acid will attack on a phenol. Just you see second stage. Okay students, so in the mechanism of RTR is nothing but Raymer-Tamman reaction. You see, phenol you are going to be used. Okay, so when the nucleophile will attack on this, this OH minus is a nucleophile that coming from the NaOH, because in main reaction you are using the NaOH. So this NaOH can abstract the proton. Okay, so when this abstract the proton, then what happens, students? The water molecule is removed like this. Okay, minus H2O is removed. So here, then what happened? This bond going to be shift, and here one pair of electron will come. Here I am shown. So what will get here? Here we will get a phenoxide ion. Okay, so phenoxide ion resonance structure, when we will get a salicylamide, so why the product should be on ortho position? So because when we can see the resonance, so the minus charge will come at ortho and para position only, because just see the in phenoxide, when you can shift this electron here, that this pi bond will going to be shift, and minus charge will come in second structure. Okay, means probably at ortho and para position minus charge will come. That's why the product, whatever we will get, the aldehyde group going to be attached at ortho position. Just see now. So here we will get a phenoxide ion. That phenoxide ion reacts with dichlorocarbene. Okay, this is a Lewis acid. Dichlorocarbene, student, is nothing but what? Lewis acid. Okay, so this Lewis acid, so here minus charge will be there. So this minus charge will attack, means this dichlorocarbene is going to be attacked to this minus charge, and here we will get a one intermediate. Already hydrogen is here. Okay, just see, when this dichlorocarbene will attack, what happened here? This pi bond going to be shift. Seeing another structure, this pi bond going to be shift here, and this whole structure going to be attached. That is CH, this Cl2. Okay, and when what happened now? This extra hydrogens. Now this hydrogen is going to be attached here. Means pi bond here will get, and this hydrogen going to be attached to this carbon here. Okay, and simultaneously this double bond going to be shift on upper side. Now clear this. So in next, let us see when this double bond going to be shift here, minus charge will come here, and this is CHCl2. Okay, so this is the intermediates. Again, we can react with 2 NMH. This intermediates reacts with 2 NMH, sodium hydroxide. You see, when this NMH reacts with this structure, what happens now? So in this NMH, 2 nucleophiles are there, 2 OH group is there. So here 2Cl, okay, and this 2Na, 2NaCl is removed, and this 2OH group going to be attached to the carbon atom. So here we will get this structure. So the remaining structure as it is, and here CH OH OH2 bands. Now see that there 2OH group is there, so it is an unstable form. So it is in unstable form. So what happens now? Water molecule is easily loose. How? This hydrogen and this OH. Okay, H2 will remove, so from this structure, so H2 will remove and we will get what here? Aldehyde group, CHO. Okay, CHO. So what happened in this intermediates? H2 will remove, there we will get a CHO aldehyde group will get. So again, this is also intermediates which on further further acidification, it undergoes acidification. Okay, so we can add the proton here, H plus ion. So what happened now? So if you add the H plus ion, so suddenly we will get this OH group here, and we finally will get the salicylamine. Okay, so this is the mechanism behind the Reimer-Damon reactions. So in next class we will discuss about the Kolbe's reaction. Okay, so students, thank you so much for watching this video.